next topic in number system, counting 8 digits. See, we know that numbers, so we'll start with the numbers from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So out of these numbers, we are using the total number of digits are 10 digits. For example, if you go with the 1 to 9, 1 to 9, we have a 9 numbers. See, 1 to 9, we have a 9 numbers. So if you form a number, we require one digit. So that's why we can call it as a single digit number. So we have a 9 numbers, we are using one digit. The total number of digits we are using from 1 to 9 is a 9 only. For example, if it is 10, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. By framing 10 to 15, how many digits we are using? See, total we have a 5 numbers, see 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And if you framing a 2 digit number, we are using 2 digits. It means we are using 5 numbers. So each number can frame with a 2 digits. The total number of digits are 10 digits only. Okay, based on these information, here question number 1. 1 to 35, find the number of digits. So this is the question. So from 1 to 35, find the number of digits in the given one. First of all, see, focus on 1 to 9. 1 to 9, we have a 9 numbers. So by making 9 numbers, they are using 1 digit. So 9 into 1, they are using total 9 digits. See, from 10 to 35. So 10 to 35, first check it out, how many 2 digit numbers are there? 2 digit number means simply 35 minus 9. Subtracted these minus these value. So 35 minus 9, the value become 26. Means the total number of 2 digits are 26. And each 2 digit number can using 2 digits. Yeah? So by forming 10 to 35, they are using each time as a 2 digit. The total numbers are 26 numbers. So 26 into 2, the 26 into 2, the total number of digits are 52. Here my question. 1 to 35, I am using the total number of digits are 61 digits. That is the concept. So we'll check one more example. 1 to 39. So if you form 1 to 39 numbers, how many digits we are using? Find the number of digits in 1 to 39. We know that 1 to 9, a single digit number. So we are using every time as a 1 digit. Means 9 into 1, the total number of digits are 9 digits. Clear? From 10 to 39, see, from 10 to 39, first of all, count it how many 2 digit numbers we are using. See, simply 39 minus 9, we are using 13 pair numbers. And by forming a 2 digit number, every time we are using a 2 digits. So 30 into 2, 32 is a 60. By making from 1 to 39, we are using 69 digits. Okay, same question for example, one more example. 1 to 99, 1 to 99, find the number of digits in 1 to 99. Same concept, just check. So first of all, 1 to 9, the total number of digits are 9 into 1 exactly equal to 9. And the same thing, from 10 to 99, from 10 to 99, first focus on how many 2 digit numbers are there. So 99 minus 9, the value become 90. And if you're framing a 2 digit number, definitely it consisting of 2 digits from every time. If you form 90 pair means we get 180 digits. Means the total number of digits from 1 to 99 is equal to 189. Let's see. From 1 to 9 we have a 9 digits. From 10 to 99, from 10 to 99, the total number of digits are 180 digits. Clear? Okay, let's see. 1 to 129. Find the number of digits in these numbers. Okay, we'll go the same approach. We already counted. 1 to 9. We are using 9 into 1 exactly equal to 9 digits. We are using 9 digits to make 1 to 9 numbers. From 10 to 99. We already calculated 10 to 99. The number of digits we are using exactly equal to 180 digits. If you want count, it means 99 minus 9. So the value become 90 into 2. We required up to 129, means more to that 100 to 129. First of all, how many 3 digits are there? See, simply 129 is subtracted from 99, simply subtracted previous value. So 129 minus 99, we are using 30 digits. So we are using 30 digits, and each digit consisting of three numbers. Three digit number consisting of three digits means the X, Y, Z is a three digit number. So by making any three digit number, we are using three numbers. So same thing. So 30 into 3 exactly equal to 90. So if we count it as entire number, the total answer is equal to 279 digits. So this is the one more important. See the question. How many digits in 1 to 999? So this is our question. First, see, simply 1 to 9, we have a 9 numbers, each number having 1 digit. 9 into 1, the total number of digits are 9 digits. Same thing, if you go with a 10 to 99, the total numbers are 90, and each number consisting of 2 digits, and 90 twos are 180 digits. And the same thing, 100 to 999, first how many numbers we are forming? Simply 999 minus 99, you can simply subtract these numbers. So 999 minus 900, the total numbers we are framing from this question is 900 numbers. And each number consisting of 3 digit number. So 900 into 3, the total numbers are 2700 numbers. So from 1 to 999, the total number of digits, see, 2889 digits. So that is your answer. The total number of digits from 1 to 999 is 2889 digits. Okay, let's see the different example from this concept. Find the last three digits in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to so on 39 digits. So this is your question. First, see, we know that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, all are single digit number. From those onwards, we have a 2-digit number. So first of all, split into how many 2-digit numbers are there, how many 1-digit numbers are there. We know that we have a 1-digit number. The 1-digit number we have only for 9. So remaining all the numbers are 2-digit numbers means simply 39 minus 9. Remaining 30 digits. Whatever the remaining 30 numbers is the 2-digit numbers. Yeah. So remaining we have a 30 numbers. Those 30 numbers are related to 2-digit numbers. 2-digit numbers means it's consisting of 2 digits. Simply those value 30 divisible by 2, the value of final become 15. That is your answer. See, after 9 we have a 15 pairs. See, we have not 15 digits, we have a 15 pairs. If we want entire resultant means the 15 number, whatever the 15 number is added with the previous number 9. So 15 plus 9, the value become 24th, means the last 2 digits are 24. It means the entire 39 digit means the last digit is equal to 24. The previous number is exactly equal to 23. The previous number belongs to 22, so on. Here my question, what is the last 3 digits? Last 3 digits is exactly equal to 324. So that is your answer. Okay, let's see the question. Find the last 2 numbers. We need to find the last 2 numbers. The given expression is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 127 digits. Not 127 is a number. So they have 127 digits. First focus on C. So we have a single digit number is equal to 9. And remaining all the numbers are 2 digit numbers. Why? Because 10 to 99 up to we have 180 digits. But here we given 127. 127 means definitely those are 2 digit numbers. First, the 127 you can subtract at 9. Why? Because these 9 numbers are single digit number. And after subtraction, we get 118 as a pair of numbers. Means each pair having a 2 digits. It means 118 divisible by 2. So 118 divisible by 2, we get the value of 59. Means After single digit, we have 59 two digit numbers. Not 59 is the last number. We have a 59 two numbers. If you want the exact expression, means the 59 number is simply add the previous resultant of 9. Means 59 plus 9, the total value become 68. Means the last resultant, whatever the last resultant is equal to 68. If you want the previous answer, previous number, 67, previous number, 66, previous number, 65, so on. In this question, we need to find the last two digits. Last two digit number is equal to 68. That is your answer. See, if number of digits are 219 digits, we already know that 1 to 9, 9 digits, 10 to 99, 180 digits. So if they given for 219 digits, definitely it is a 3 digit number. So how we are focusing? See, we already know that 1 to 9, we have completed 9 digits. Then 10 to 99, 10 to 99 is we have completed 180 digits. Means 189 digits is a combination of single digit and a 2 digit. And remaining all the numbers are 3 digit numbers. Just focus on, after 189, how many digits we are left? Means 219 is subtracted as 189. So if you subtracted these value, it says 0 and 30 numbers. So these 30 numbers is a part of a 3 digit numbers, means it consisting of 3 variables. That's why 30 divisible by 3. So the total number of 3 pair numbers are 10 only. Clear? And we already know that the single digit highest number is a 9. 2 digit highest number is 99. After 99, we have a 10 numbers. Means 99 plus 10, the exact resultant is equal to 109. Means last digit of a number is equal to 109. And the previous number 108, the previous number 107, so on. He said that what is the last 3 digit number? What is the last 3 digits here? 109 be the answer. Yeah. See, if they given for number of digits greater than 180, you need to recognize that there is a 3 digit number. That's why the 189 is subtracted from 299, we get a 30 numbers. Those 30 numbers is related to 3 digit number. That's why those 30 is divisible by 30, we are forming a 10 3 digit number. And these 10 numbers we are added after 99. Why? Because the 2 digit highest number is equal to 99. We simply add 10 into the 99. The entire resultant is equal to 109. So these number can exactly indicate a last 3 digit number. So same model they given in terms of remainder. Find the remainders. There is a 41 digit number which is divisible by 8. See, if divisible by 8 property says focus on last 3 digits. If you focus on last 3 digits, we get the direct reminders. Okay, see, the total we have a 41 digits. Out of 41 digits, we have a 9 single digit number. That's why 41 is subtracted from 9. 41 minus 9, the value become exactly 32. Means 32 digits which are consisting of a 2 digit number. That's why 32 is divisible by 2. The total numbers after 1 digit is equal to 16 numbers. If we want resultant, means simply 9 plus 16, the total value is equal to 25. It means the last numbers are 25 and the previous number 24, the previous number 23, so on. According to the divisible by 8 rule, you just focus on last 3 digits. See, if you focus on last 3 digits, means 425 divisible by 8. See, what is the remainder here? 8 ones are 8, 8 fives are 40. Clear? So 8 ones are 8, 8 fives are 40, and we have 2 as a forward, and 8 threes are 24, and we get 1 as the remainder. Means those particular number is exactly divisible by 8, we get remainder with the 1. This is the important in digits concept. Focus on number of single 1 digit, 2 digit and 3 digits. Clear? See, if find the remainder for these expression which is divisible by 16. See, first of all, focus on the 16 properties. The divisibility rule for 16, focus on last 4 digits. If you know the last 4 digits, we get the remainder for entire number. Okay, they given as a 56 digits. So 56 is subtracted 9. So if 56 is subtracted 9, we get a 35. So 35 is divisible by 2, we get a points. That's why pick a odd number digit. I just pick a 55 in the previous digit. Clear? Then same thing, 55 digits is subtracted a single digit number. We get the resultant is equal to 46. It means after single digit number, we have 46 two digit numbers are available. If you want the exact number, means 46 divisible by 2, we get the value of 23. If you get 23 as a resultant, previously we have a 9 numbers, the entire resultant is exactly equal to 32. Means this is the 32 number for 55th digit, not a 56th digit. See, if you want 55 digit, means 55 digit is equal to 33, then the previous number 31, the previous number 30, so on. But if you want to 56 digit, means see, these are related to 30s, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. After 32, the next number is equal to 33, but we required only one digit. If you required only one digit, means I just consider as 3 only. Then here my question, if you want these number which is divisible by 16, means focus on last 3 digits. What is the last 3 digits here? 1323 divisible by 16. See, concentrated, 16 become how many times? 16 8s are 128. So we left with 43 as a remainder. And same thing, 16 2s are 32, we get a remainder is 11 only. It means if these entire number which is divisible by 16, we get the remainder is equal to 11. So these are the different models which are related to the digits concept. Yeah. Okay, next see. Find the numbers between 100 to 200. How many are there? If both ends are counted, only one is counted and both ends are excluded. Before this example, I just explain with a smaller number. From 1 to 10, the 1 to 10, the total numbers are 10 only. It means we including first number and we are including last number. Clear? For example, if you excluding these two numbers, the total, if you excluding ends, the total numbers, if you excluding ends, we have a 8 numbers. If both are including, we have 10 numbers. If only one end is including, the total numbers are 9 only. Means out of 1 or 10, you can consider only one particular end. These are the 3 examples. If you go with the direct approach, see, if you including the both the numbers, if you including both the numbers, means 10 minus 1 plus 1, that is the theory. So if we can subtract it, final number minus initial number, we can add with a 1. 10 minus 1 plus 1, the total numbers are 10 only. If you excluding both the ends, means final end minus starting end, we can subtract it minus 1, means 10 minus 1, again we can subtract it minus 1. Why? Because while we counting a numbers, we including both the one. But here my question, we need to excluding the ends. If same thing, if only one end is included, means simply final value minus initial value, that is the resultant. In the same way, if find the numbers between 100 to 200, if any number is given, we need to find how many numbers are there. Here my question, if you consider both the ends, means 200 minus 100, we need to add plus 1. Why? Because we are addition both the ends. If you including both the ends, we are added a number. The total resultant is equal to 101. Means 100 to 200, the total numbers are 101. He said that if you including only one end, means simply the final value minus initial value, the total resultant is equal to 100 only. If he said that if you are excluding both the numbers, means we are excluding 100 and 200. If you excluding both the numbers, simply subtract 200 minus 100. Again, you can subtract minus 1. The total resultant, the total numbers between 100 to 200, excluding both the ends, is equal to 99. See, if you want to including both the ends, means difference plus 1. See, if you want including both the ends, means difference plus 1. That is the answer. If the question related for only one end is included, your answer is related to difference between the number. If you cannot consider both the ends, if you excluding both the end, means your answer related to difference between the numbers, again minus 1. So this is the theory. If you counting a numbers between the any digits. Between the any numbers is given, we are counting. This is the approach. So concentrated, if you both ends are included or both ends are excluded or only one end is included. So concentrated on the questions. We go with the divisible calculation. These are the 10 numbers. Here my question. From 1 to 100, see, if the question related from 1 to 100 means we consider first number between last number. You can consider the entire 10 numbers. That is the meaning of from. So out of these 10 numbers, how many numbers are divisible by 2? So 2 is a divisible, 4 is a divisible, 6 is a divisible, 8 is divisible and 10 is divisible. The total number of 2 divisible numbers are 5. If we want to go with the direct one, means focus on the last number. The last number which is divisible by 2. If last number which is divisible by 2, 10 divisible by 2, the total numbers are 5 only. Here same question, between 1 to 10, between 1 to 10 means we need to eliminate first number and last number. So if we just eliminated first number and last number, we can get the remaining one. If you count it as a remaining means 2, 4, 6, 8, the total numbers are 4 only. If you want to go with this direct one, focus on the last number, the last number is equal to 10 and 10 is divisible by 2, we get the value of 5. But 5 is not an answer, why? Because he said that we need to count it from 1 to 10. So between numbers we required. First focus on 10. If 10 is divisible by 2 means we can consider these counting also. That's why those counting is subtracted from 5. So the total number of digits between 1 to 10 which is divisible by 2 is exactly equal to 4 only. So observe that if the question is related from 1 to 10 means you just including 1 and 10. The question related from between 1 to 10 means we just excluded 1 and 10. If your number is exactly divisible the given number, we need to subtract those number. Why? Because we required between numbers only. See the first question. From 1 to 5000, how many numbers which is exactly divisible by 90? So we required from means we consider first number and last number. Simply, the last, whatever the last number which is exactly divisible by 9. Focus on the exact cancellation. See, 9 become a 10. It's a 5 times 9 5s are 45. Again forward, 9 5s are 45. Again 9 5s are 45. We have a decimal. Again 9 5s are 45. So on. Means, these number is not exactly divisible by 9. Means, simply eliminate the decimal values. It means the question, if 1 to 5000, the total number of divisibles by 9 exactly equal to 555. That is your answer. Between 1 to 5400, how many numbers which is divisible by 6? Same thing. We are question concentration part be the between. Between means we need to eliminate the first number and the last number. First, take it as the last number. 5400 is exactly divisible by 6. So 6 become a 54. Exactly, there are 900 numbers. So out of 900 numbers, they including 5400. But my question is related between the numbers. Means we need to excluding 5400. That is the one number. It means your calculation is related for 899. It means between 1 to 5400, the total number of divisibles by 6 is 899 numbers. Let's see the next question. From 1 to 6000, how many numbers which is divisible by 3 and 4 both? 3 and 4 both means the common multiple of 3 and 4 is the exact divisible number. They're given as 3 and 4 means the LCM. Find the LCM of 3 and 4. What is the common multiple of 3 and 4? That is exactly 12. Means how many numbers between 1 to 6000 which is exactly divisible by 12. That is the meaning of 3 and 4 both. Simply our answer related to 6000 divisible by 2. If 6000 divisible by 2, the total numbers are 500. Why? Because 12 5s are 60. If same question related for between 1 to 6000. Between 1 to 6000 means 6000 is exactly divisible by 12. Means those number is subtracted from 500. Then your answer is related to 500 minus 1. The answer is related to 499. See the question. From 1 to 6000, the total numbers are 500. Between 1 to 6000, the total numbers which is divisible by 12 is equal to 499. So just see the question from or between. Same. between 200 to 900, if they given for 200 to 900, how many numbers which is divisible by 4 and 6 both? 4 and 6 both means the total LCM of 4 and 6 is equal to 3. But here the numbers are not 1 to 900. First of all, concentrated, how many divisibles are there from 1 to 200? See, if 200 is divisible by 12, how many numbers are there? Just check it out. So 12 ones are 12, 80 be the carry forward, and 12 6 are 72. The total numbers are 16. See, 200 is not a divisible number. And second one. So just check it out, how many numbers are between 1 to 900? So 1 to 900 means if 900 is exactly divisible by 12. So 900 is exactly divisible by 12, how many are there? Just check it out. So 12 become 12 7s are 84. So 12 5s are 68, means 900 is exactly divisible. So that is the important point we need to note here. And 12 is not exactly divisible. Okay, from 1 to 900 the total numbers we are 75, from 1 to 200 we have 60 numbers. My question, between 200 to 900 how many numbers are there? Means 75 minus 16, the total numbers are 59. But you can just 59 as answer, but remember that we required between, means we need to excluding exact 900 divisible number. Why? Because 900 is exactly divisible by 12 means we need to subtract those number also. This is the important point. So that's why your answer is related to 58, not a 59. Clear? See, if 900 divisible means these number is also included. First, we need to excluding those number. That is your final resultant. Clear? See, here from 1 to 300, how many numbers are divisible by either 2 or 3? What is the meaning of either 2 or 3? Either or can define as, you can consider only one case, either A case or B case, but we cannot consider together. So that is the meaning of either or. If you go to the Venn diagram, see, they deals with the one circle, that is A, and they deals with the other circle B. So this particular space is defined with only A section, means this section is not intersected with B. And this section is intersected with only B. And this is the combination of both A and B. Previous question they are discussing for both A and B. For this question we can choose as either 2 or 3. Means you can choose either these case or these case only. But out of these two cases we cannot confirm a particular case. That's why focus on from 1 to 300 means we just including numbers from 1 to all 300 numbers. So 300 is divisible by 2, we get the total numbers are 150. If maybe that is divisible by 3 means 300 divisible by 3, the total numbers we left is 100. But these 150 numbers and these 100 numbers, it is a combination of both 2 and 3. Why? Because for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, for example. So how many 2 divisibles are there? 1, 2, 3, so those are 2, 4, 6, 8. If same question, how many 3 divisibles are there? 3, 6. The total numbers we can conclude as 6. But this is the wrong answer. Why? Because 6 can be counted as 2 times. Those 2 times we can subtract at 1 time only. That's why the 300 which is divisible by 6, focus on 6 also. Why? Because the LCM of 2 and 3 is exactly equal to 6 only. Clear? If 300 divisible by 6, we have a common multiple, 50 common multiples of 2 and 3. Those 50 we can subtract from these numbers. Then the final resultant of this question, 150 plus 100 minus 50, the total numbers are 200 numbers. The 200 numbers which are divisible by either 2 or 3. So see, if the question is related for either 2, either or case means we can consider only one case and we can subtract a common case. That is the important part. Yeah. Okay. If the questions are related to not divisible cases, how many numbers are not divisible by number? See, if you consider as these numbers, if you go with how many 3 multiples are there, means the 3 multiple we get every 3 numbers. See, so 3 get every 3 numbers, we get a 3 multiple. Means 3 multiples are 3, 6, 9, and 12. Here my question, out of 1 to 12, how many 3 divisibles are there? So we have a 4 divisibles. how many numbers which is not divisible by 3? Means the total number 12 minus 4, 8 numbers is not divisible by 3. If it is a larger number, not divisible case be the difficult. Why? Because not divisible can indicate it total minus divisible. So we just focus on the other concept. See, here see, out of 3 numbers, we have a 3 numbers. Out of 3 numbers, we have a 1 divisible. Means out of 3 numbers, we don't have 2 divisibles. Clear? That's why if the question is related for not divisible by 3, means we can consider the fraction is equal to 2 by 3. Here denominator can indicate a total value and numerator is indicated not divisible number. It means here I will give the example. From all these numbers, if 3 divisible by 12, the total number is belongs to the 4. And same thing, 2 into 4, the total value become 8. Means out of 12 numbers, 8 numbers are not divisible by 3. If same concept, if not divisible by 7, how many numbers are there in not divisible by 7? See, every 7 numbers, if you've concentrated on every 7 numbers, 6 numbers are not divisible by 7. It means the fraction is a representation of 6 by 7. Means out of all the numbers, 6 numbers are not divisible by 7. If same concept, if not divisible by 5, if you consider as a 5 numbers, out of 5 numbers, 4 numbers are not divisible by 5. So you can consider these type of fractions. Okay, if you go to the same question, from 1 to 12, how many numbers are not divisible by 2 and 3? This is your question. See, out of 2, 1 number is not divisible. If you want to 3 not divisible, means we have a 3 numbers. Out of 3, 2 numbers are not divisible. Then 2 cancel, we left the fraction is equal to 1 by 3. Then 3 can be represented total value. So 12 is exactly cancelled, means 3 become a 12 4 times. Again 1 into 4 exactly equal to 4. From 1 to 12, 4 numbers are not divisible by 2 or 3. Just concentrate it. 2 and 3 divisible means this is divisible, 6 divisible, 8 divisible, 9 divisible, 12 divisible. And 2 and 3 and 10 is also divisible. And count it final numbers. We have a 1 number, 5, 7 and 11. Total we have a 4 numbers. This is the not divisible concept. Clear? So application, just check with application. See, from 1 to 900, how many numbers are neither divisible by 2, 3, 5? We need to consider how many numbers are not at all divisible by 2, 3, 5. I will tell you the concept. Out of every 2 number, we have 1 number is not divisible. If you want 3, means out of 3 numbers, 2 numbers are not divisible. Out of 5 numbers, 4 numbers are not divisible. Then check with the calculation. Here 2 cancel, the final calculation be the 4 by 5 3s are 15. See, if you from 1 to 900 means you consider 900 also. So 900 is exactly cancellation of 900. Sorry, 15 is exactly cancellation of 900. See, if 5 become a 900, check how many terms, how many times it is. So 15 becomes 6. 15, 6 are 90, and we have a 60 times. If 15 become a 900, that is 60 times 4 into 60. The total number is equal to 240. Clear? So from 1 to 900. The numbers which is not divisible by 2, 3, 5, those are 240 numbers. For example, if same question, if the question related for 1 to 1000, how many digits which are not divisible by 2, 3, 5? Same concept. So out of 2 numbers, 1 number is not divisible. Out of 3 numbers, 2 numbers are not divisible. Out of 5 numbers, 4 numbers are not divisible. Then the final fraction become 4 by 15. Okay, just go with the calculation. And 1000 is not divisible by 15. Consider nearest multiple. The nearest multiple I just consider as 990. Then concentrated. 15 become a 66 times. So 15, 66 are 990. Consider the exact divisible number. That's why I just consider 990. And 15, 66 are 990. And 4 into 66. 4, 66 are 6, 4 are 24. 4, 6 are 24. Then answer is equal to 264. but we have a doubt, sir. We consider up to 1000, but you consider 990. That's why remaining numbers you can count it in manual way. Means what are the remaining numbers? 991, 992, 993, 994, 995, 996, 997, 998, 999, and 1000. So just check it out. Out of these three numbers, what are the numbers which is not divisible by 235? We know that according to the two rule, 992 is divisible by 2, and 993 is divisible by 3, and 996 is also divisible by 3, 999 is divisible by 3, 1000 is divisible by 5 and undivisible by 2, and 998 is also divisible by 2. And check with the remaining number, 991, 994 is divisible by 2, 995, 997. See, these are all the three numbers which is not divisible by those number. Just check with, 995 is also divisible by 5. Means 991, 997 is not at all divisible by 2, 3, 5. Then the answer belongs to add 2. So the total numbers which is not divisible by 2, 3, 5 in 1 to 1000 are 266 numbers. Those are the answer. So one more question for neither nor. The question related from 700 to 950, which is not divisible by 3 or 7. First frame a fraction part for 3, 7. Out of 3 numbers, 2 numbers are not divisible. Out of 7 numbers, 6 numbers are not divisible. Then the fraction 3 become 2 times. The fraction is exactly equal to 4 by 7. First, I just calculated from 1 to 700. 1 to 700, how many numbers are not divisible by 3 or 7? We already know that 7 and 700 is exactly cancelled. So 7 become a 700 is a 100 times. Out of 7, 400s are not divisible. Means the answer is equal to 400. And second one, we need to focus on 1 to 950. See, 950 is divisible by 7 or not. Just check it out, 950 is divisible by 7 or not. See, 7 ones are 7 and 20, 7 threes are 21, 4 and 7 fives are 35. We left with extra forward as a 5. Means we left with a remainder 5. Means 945 is exactly divisible by 7 in 135 times. Means we just whatever the 5 remainders, so whatever the 5 numbers, we can go with the manual. Okay, then 945 is divisible by 7. We left with 135 numbers. It means 135 is a multiple with 4. Why? Because this is 100 is multiple with 4 and this is 135 is divisible by, sorry, multiple with a 4. Means the answer is equal to 400 plus 35 4s are 35, 2s are 70, 72s are 140. The total answer is equal to 540. From 1 to 950 we have a 540 numbers, 1 to 700 we have a 400 numbers. But here we are checking up to 945, but here my number is related to 950. So concentrated on nine remaining numbers. Remaining numbers means 946, 947, 948, 949 and 950. Concentration on these numbers which is divisible by 3 or 7. See, according to 3 rule, sum of all digits and 7 rule, subtracted from last digit and double it and subtracted from the previous number. See, out of all these numbers, 948 is exactly divisible by 3. Why? Because the property 3 says sum of its digits. Sum of its digits means, see, 8 plus 4, 12 is cancelled and 3 is cancelled. And remaining 4 numbers are not divisible by 3 or 7. Means 1 to 950, the total numbers which is not divisible by 7. Sorry, 3 or 7 is equal to 544. From 1 to 700, we have a 400 numbers. 1 to 950, we have a 544 numbers. But here my question related for 700 to 950, the total numbers are 544 minus 400. The total is equal to 144 numbers between 700 to 950, which is not divisible by 3 nor 7. Clear?